All right, guys, welcome to another episode of Flipping the Max Cash on RS3. In this episode, we get a lot of flips here. As you can see, to start off, we flip some oak planks, aggression potions, and mahogany planks, and we ended up making 1.6 mil. This was continuation of after double XP, or double XP was still going on for a little bit, so these were at the tail end of last episode, and we ended up making a nice 1.6 mil. And after this, I actually bought a Mizuari for 4.7 mil here, and I put it in for a way low ball offer. So I was very surprised when it bought, but if it does sell, we should be making a lot of money. And as you can see here, it ends up selling. I had to lower the price a bit, but we did make about 1,050,000 off that. And then we made about 250,000 off all these incense sticks that we had also bought. So in total, we made about 1.3 mil from these few flips. And of course, the biggest flip was the Mizuari. I actually did try to buy some more Mizuaris after this, but sadly they didn't buy. So I got pretty lucky with that one. And that's sometimes just how it goes. The margin runs out on some things. After this, we actually bought and sold 1,400 incense sticks. So basically, my whole cash stack worth of incense sticks. And if you look here, we made about 1.3 mil off them. So incense sticks are very good to flip because people want them for PVMing super fast. So they usually have a decent margin. After this, these became my bread and butter this episode. We sold four Ancient Warriors equipment patches and a Vesta spear. So I basically got the Vesta spear for pretty cheap, under a mil, and then the Ancient Warrior equipment patches I got for 9 mil each. So I ended up making 2.2 mil off the patches and almost 800K, 700K on the V spear. So we made almost 3 mil from these few flips. And as you'll see later, we continue with the Ancient Warrior equipment patches because they were just so good. So here we sold some spirit weed incense sticks, which again, love flipping the incense sticks, and we flipped more of the patches. So we actually made about 600K off one patch and the incense sticks. So not too bad, not as big a margin on the sticks as I wanted, but profit is profit. After this, I continued with the Ancient Warrior equipment patches, and I was just buying them for about 9 mil each, and then I was selling them for about 9.4 to about 9.5 mil each. So on these, we ended up making 1.6 mil on another four Ancient Warrior equipment patches. So really, really good. And then again, I ended up buying four more Ancient Warrior equipment patches. The limit was every 4 hours, so I would do this every 4 hours. I would keep flipping these while I was, trying out the new boss. Yeah, we ended up selling these here for 9.4 mil each, and we made 1.2 mil off three of these Ancient Warrior equipment patches. So not too bad there. Honestly, finding an item like this, you just have to keep looking and keep searching. If you can't find anything to flip, just keep looking through different things and trying out different items, because eventually you're gonna find one that sticks and you're gonna be able to, flip it as much as you can until that profit margin runs out. Don't stop flipping it. Flip it really as much as you can until it just isn't working anymore, and try to get as much money out of a certain item and its margins as possible, like I did with the Ancient Warrior equipment patches, because once I saw that margin and how fast they were honestly buying, I would just put an offer in, buy them, sell them, and here we sell our last Ancient Warrior equipment patch. They stopped working after this, but we made another 400K off those. And I moved on. I started flipping onyxes because the new boss came out, so a lot of people needed onyxes to charge their Ring of Death because they were dying. And we made about 1 mil off these onyxes. As you can see, they're going for over 4 mil each. So we made about 100K off each onyx, which was really good. I was very surprised that onyxes had that much of a margin. After this, I ended up buying these overnight, actually. So I bought a Pernix body, Pernix boots, and some Lantadine incense sticks. So those ended up buying overnight, and as you can see, they sold almost instantly. As you can see there, The Pernix body sold, the boots sold. If you look at the clock in the right-hand corner, these sold minutes later after I put them in. And we ended up making 1.9 mil off the body, boots, and incense sticks. I think we made 900K off the Pernix body, a nice 250K off the boots, and then, another good 600-700K off the incense sticks. So, I mean, this was a really, really successful flip, almost 2 mil total in this flip, and it was my first time actually, flipping an item, I believe, as expensive as the Pernix body. I know I've done, like, Virtus Mask and items like that in the previous episodes, but, I was pleasantly surprised with it. It wasn't as good as the Ancient Warrior equipment patches, and the one items like this can always be tricky because you can't check the margins yourself. You kind of have to guess, so it is possible to lose money if the price fluctuates up and down, which is why, at this stage, I'm a little bit scared to go for the big items like this, just because, you know, as you see the incense sticks there, the onyxes, the equipment patches, I'm making so much money off relatively safe items that I didn't really want to venture too far out into the Pernix bodies and, you know, things like that. But I know we're going to do that once we get more money. But overall, I mean, really, really good flips here. And like I said, I bought these overnight, so I was afraid when I woke up they were going to, like, have plummeted in price. But luckily for me, kind of just the opposite happened. They actually spiked a bit in price, so that is kind of why we made so much profit there. And not a bad flip. And moving on, we actually sold some more onyxes, and they're going for 4.2 mil each here. And we ended up making about 950K off 10 onyxes, so 95K in onyx. Again, really, really good. Onyxes were decent this episode. And if you saw in the last clip, we ended up buying some Vestas longswords for 250K each, real low ball, but it actually ended up working out, and I sold them for 750K. So I like doing that, like lowballing rare items like that. And I sold the other longsword here for another 500K profit. So it was really successful kind of buying the Revenant items for way cheaper, because a lot of times people dump those. So really, really successful flips this episode. I was really happy with all the money we made. All right, guys, so we're going to end off episode 3 of Road to Max Cash while flipping here. If we look in our inventory, we have 52.3 million coins, which I believe last episode, we actually ended with 36.8 mil coins. So we made almost 16 mil this episode, which is really, really good. I tried more expensive items, and funny enough, some of the more expensive items you don't make as much money on as you do with some of, like, the resource items. So, like, I tried things like, Nex Armors, and I made a decent amount of money on them, but I didn't make, like, a ton of money. Like, there were some supplies that I would make, like, for instance, I think I made a few mil off just onyxes, I tie up all my money in, like, one big item. I'm not going to make as much as if I buy a lot of smaller items for some scenarios. Now, once I get to things, like, now I can actually start flipping, like, dry gores and stuff like that. And I think next episode we're going to be flipping things like that and actually start making a lot more money and see this number increase even more. I hope next episode we can double this and hit about 100 mil. So make sure you subscribe so you can see the next episode. But I wanted to thank all my channel members. Thank you for supporting me. If you'd like to join my channel memberships, there will be a box that pops up on the screen, or you can click the join button on my channel or at the bottom of the video here. And you can, you know, support the channel, join my channel memberships, and you can get a bunch of cool perks like PVM with me, get added on Discord, get shouted out at the end of videos, stuff like that. So I just want to thank all my current channel members. And if you guys like this video, make sure to subscribe and like the video down below. Comment and tell me what you think I should flip in the next episode. Give me some ideas. I'm always looking for different items to flip. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next video.